We're unable to bring you the advertised recital live from the Queen's Hall in Edinburgh for contractual reasons. So instead, we're broadcasting the recital Galina Gorchakova gave at last year's Edinburgh International Festival. She was accompanied by Larissa Gergieva in songs by six Russian composers, Tchaikovsky, Rachmaninoff, GLINKA, BALAKIEREV, RIMSKY-KORSAKOV and DARGHOMINSKY. And she opens with a trio of songs by GLINKA, beginning with the lark. As the tiny bird hovers suspended between heaven and earth, its song flows in an endless stream. Who knows who'll hear it carried away on the breeze? But she'll know who my song comes from. She'll know someone will remember me and sigh in secret. But there's no such certainty in the next song. You'll soon forget me. But I'll never forget you. You'll fall in and out of love again, not me. You'll choose new friends, new feelings, perhaps even know happiness, but not me. Only the grave will know how much I loved and suffered. And the final song sets words by Pushkin, his passionate recollection of seeing the beautiful Anna Petrovna Kern 6 years after they'd first met at a ball in St. Petersburg in 1819. I remember that wonderful moment. You appeared in front of me like a fleeting vision of pure beauty. Long after, in the languor of hopeless sadness, I heard your tender voice, and in dreams I saw your heavenly face. But years passed, and I forgot your voice, your face. In the backwoods, I eked out my days without inspiration, without life, without love. And then I saw you again. GLINKA sets Pushkin's poem for Anna Petrovna's daughter, 30 years after that first meeting. The rest of the programme will be presented by Donald MacLeod, who was at this recital from last year's Edinburgh International Festival. Here then are three songs by GLINKA, sung by Galina Gorchakova, accompanied by Larissa Gergieva.
Thank you.
coming face to face again after many years with the vision of loveliness he'd almost forgotten, but who changed his life completely, Pushkin's soul awakened, and with it came back inspiration and tears and life and love. Glinka set those verses for the daughter of the woman who'd inspired them, Anna Petrovna Kern. Galina Gorchakova was accompanied by Larissa Gergieva. Now, the real rarities of their programme, a group of songs by Alexander Darghomishki. Pushkin was the inspiration for the only work of his which most of us in the West could name, the opera The Stone Guest. You may have taken the chance to see it at English National Opera a few years ago. Well, the second of this group of songs sets a poem by Pushkin, but first come words by Deltic. I'm past my 16th birthday now, and my heart was unspoken for. I used to think that our woods, our stream, our fields were the whole world. But then a young man came to our village, I don't know where from, and everything drew me to him. Everything said, it's him, he's the one. But then he took my hand and pressed it, told me gently that he loved me, but I couldn't find the words, could only look down and blush. So why did he get angry? Why did he turn and go? The Pushkin poem is a funny little romance. A jealous girl, crying bitterly, reproaches the young man leaning on her shoulder. Then she notices that he's dropped off to sleep. She falls silent and smiles, but goes on sobbing into a hanky. A performance of the third song by Pauline Viardot-Garcia in 1853 was such a big hit that it inspired a poem in itself. The original poem sounds a familiar note. I still love him madly. My soul shudders at his very name. Longing overwhelms me, and I can't stop the tears. Fool that I am, I still love him. And infatuation is the subject of the last of this group. What are those songs to me? What do I care for the songs of birds? You sing more sweetly. What do I care for meadows full of spring flowers? You're much more beautiful. What do I care if the stars fade in the heavens? All the stars of the night are there in your eyes. All the songs of paradise, all the colours of the fields, all the stars of the heavens are in your love. Here once again, Galina Gorchakova and Larissa Gergieva to perform four songs by Darghomishky.
Yeah.
A first hearing for most of us here in the Queen's Hall in Edinburgh. I don't know about you. Four songs by Alexander Darghominsky, whom Glinka described as a musical psychologist. The soprano is Galina Gorchakova and the pianist Larisa Gergieva. Next in their live recital from the Queen's Hall in Edinburgh, three songs by Balakirev. Bright Moon paints a picture of a lover waiting in the blue shadows of a spring night as the moon silvers the sky and mists float over the fields. If only she'd come. If only she'd come. The next song presents a catalogue of captivating charms. Your luxuriant beauty, the guile of your eyes, the whiteness of your shoulders, your intoxicating glance, the beauty of your speech which draws everyone to you. It's impossible not to look at you. Anyone who hears your voice just once longs for nothing but to hear you talk all day long. Russian songwriters in the last century seem to have had a preoccupation with Spain. Tuesday's recital made that pretty clear. And here's another instance from Balakirev called Just Spanish Song. The young man calls up from the street, "Are you asleep? Open the shutters. Now's our chance to elope. If you haven't already put on your little satin slippers, don't worry, you won't need them. You'll get your feet wet because our way takes us through the torrents of the river Guadalquivir." So now, in three songs by Balakirev, The Bright Moon, Your Entrancing Charms, and Spanish Song here once again are Galina Gorchakova and Larisa Gergieva.
Thank you.
No need for fancy footwear then for the young Spanish couple eloping across the torrents of the Guadalquivir. A rather damp prospect in Spanish song, the last of that trio of songs by Balakirev, performed by Galina Gorchakova and Larissa Gergieva. We end the first half of their live recital from Edinburgh with a pair of songs by Rimsky-Korsakov, both with images of birdsong. You'll hear at once in the music that the first has an oriental flavour. The nightingale's in love with the rose, and he sings to her night and day. She listens silently. Elsewhere, a singer pours out his heart to the sound of a lyre. A young girl listens, though she can't understand why his songs are so sad. And then, clearer than the lark's song, more brilliant than the colours of spring flowers, the heart is inspired. The sky glows with beauty, breaking the chains of sadness and unleashing a new wave of life, like a choir of heavenly voices singing between earth and sky. The nightingale and the rose, and clearer than the lark's song. Two songs by Rimsky-Korsakov, performed now by Galina Gorchakova and Larissa Gergieva.
Thank you.
clearer than the lark song, and before it, the nightingale and the rose, both by Rimsky-Korsakov. That ends the first part of this recital of Russian song, given at last year's Edinburgh Festival by Galina Gorchakova, accompanied by Larisa Gergieva. The first, or three anyway, of the Tchaikovsky songs are about love at different stages. First, youthful love. Don't believe me when I say I don't love you any longer, any more than you'd trust the sea at the ebb tide. Watch out, it's treacherous, and it'll return to the land as a lover. Already I'm beginning to yearn for you. Already the waves are rushing back noisily to the shore. Next, from a set of children's songs, comes a lullaby. It sets a little nursery rhyme about a tiny little man who's so small he can make himself two shirt fronts from a mosquito's wings. Then it's back to the preoccupations of the grown-ups and the nostalgia of past love. To forget so soon, my God, all the happiness of the life we had together. The excitement of the first days, all our meetings, the silent conversations of our eyes, how the moon shone through the window. To forget so soon. To forget the love, to forget the dreams, to forget those promises. Do you remember? And last, one of those meetings that's not been forgotten. It was in the early spring. The grass had hardly come up. There was a birch tree in the shade. With a smile, you lowered your eyes before me. That was in the morning of our years. Oh, happiness. Oh, life. Oh, the sweet smell of birch. Now here, to perform these four songs by Tchaikovsky, once again, Galina Gorchakova and Larisa Gergieva.
Remembrance of things past comes about not by the taste of Madeleine, but in that last Tchaikovsky song, by the sweet smell of birch trees in the early spring. Galina Gorchakova was accompanied by Larisa Gergieva. Well, they end their recital now by turning to Rachmaninoff and a group of his early songs, all written before he was 30. First, Don't Sing to Me, Fair Maiden, those old sad songs of Georgia. They remind me of another life and a distant shore. Those tunes remind me of the steppe and the night and the moonlit features of a girl I loved. The next song is about homesickness too. It's one we heard in Tuesday's recital as well, and it's a translation of Heine. Memories of a distant country, of a pine tree gently swaying overhead, a family of friends still alive and surrounded by loving words. Ah, but it's only a dream. And the taste of life has turned bitter in the next song too. I was so fond of my little orphan boy, the man I married, but now they've taken him away, hauled him off to the army, and they've left me alone here, a stranger in this village, maybe forever, to grow old in a strange hut. And the mood doesn't lighten in the very last song of all. Loneliness sets part of a poem by Alfred de Musset called May Night. Why does a sick heart beat more intensely and beg and thirst for rest? What do I fear at night? The door knocks, the rays of the lamp flash as it sputters and goes out. My God, I can't breathe. Someone's calling me. There's someone here. But no, I was mistaken. I'm alone here in my cell. There, that's the sound of midnight striking. So here to end their recital, Galina Gorchakova and the pianist Larisa Georgieva in four songs by Rachmaninoff. Sing Not to Me, Fair Maiden, A Dream, The Soldier's Wife, and Loneliness.
Thank you.
An evocation of the dark night of the Russian soul, admittedly setting a poem which was originally French, part of a poem by Okhodivisi, set there by Rachmaninoff, Loneliness, the last of that quartet of songs by Rachmaninoff, performed by Galina Gorchakova and Larissa Georgieva. Who's already been presented with a small bouquet of flowers from a member of the audience who rushed up at once. As you've been able to hear from the response throughout this recital, Gorchakova has scored a very firm success. and I don't think there's the slightest chance of her getting away without giving this audience an encore. Not a metropolitan young woman, she was born in Novokuznetsk, and she studied initially at the Novosibirsk Music Academy. A prize winner in the Mussorgsky and Glinka competitions, and 6 years ago she joined the Svetlovsk Opera Company. Her roles there included some that you'd expect, I guess, Tatiana in Eugene Onegin, Yaroslavna in Prince Igor, Clara in Prokofiev's The Duenna, but also Cho-Cho-San in Butterfly and Santuzza in Cavalleria Rusticana. And another official-looking bouquet presented, but laid on the piano.
Thank you.
And in one leap, Galina Gorchakova taking us straight off the song recital platform and onto the operatic stage. And into a row, Leonora in Verdi's Trovatore, which she sung at the Malinsky, formerly the Kirov Theatre. Cavatina and Cavaletta, Caccia la Notte. And scoring a conspicuous success. Lots of smiling faces and glowing eyes. A role that I can see her fitting extremely well. She has almost jet black hair and eyes. She also has a wonderfully healthy, a fairly dark complexion. Good deal of makeup necessary to make her convincing in Traviata, for instance. And I think we're going to have something more.
Music from Puccini's Madame Butterfly.